Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube. Power BI has some new additions inside of Microsoft Teams. We're going to check it out. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Microsoft Teams and Power BI. At Microsoft Ignite, they showed off some of the new Teams integration that Power BI was going to have, and it's finally available. So let's dig into this. And you know what? Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and check it out. All right, Microsoft Teams, you may be using it, you may be not, but here is what Power BI can do for you inside of Teams. Let me just recap real quick, like what has existed already. So hopefully if you're using Teams and Power BI, you already know this. All you have to do is click on the little plus up on the top. We can go to Power BI, and inside of here, we can see our reports and apps and items that we have. I can then choose a report, save it. I'm not gonna post it in the channel, and bam, we've got a Power BI report inside of Microsoft Teams. You can interact with it. You can do all sorts of stuff and stay with inside of Teams. You can also share these items from a chat perspective and share visuals as well and do copy paste into Teams chat. So all of that's been available for a while now, nothing new there. What I wanna highlight though is this is in the context of a given channel in a team, but what about Power BI all up? The new addition we have, if we come over to the ellipsis over here, we can go and do Power BI. You will see Power BI. And then from here, we will see the app itself. This part was a little confusing for me. First time I did it, I'm like, maybe I don't have it yet, but let me explain. So you'll see add, and if you click on the dropdown, you'll see add to team and add to chat. And I was like, if those are the two items, how do I get it over here on the bar? So I just hit add, that's all it was. And then it shows up over on the bar. So Power BI is now inside of Teams. Before you do anything else, please do this one thing. You will thank me later. Right click on the Power BI icon and do pin. So now it will always be there. Otherwise, if you moved out of context, it'll like disappear and you'll be like, where did Power BI go? You could have also gotten there if you just hit the ellipsis, it would show up there as well. So let me show unpin. And if we go back to Teams, and then you'll see Power BI right there. It'll go right back to it. Not a big deal. All right, I'm gonna repin it. From here, this looks pretty familiar. It's the Power BI home area, and it is inside of Teams now. So you don't have to leave Teams to go explore Power BI reports. That's one of the amazing things. Everything you would expect to be here is here. So you can see workspaces, we can look at content, I can pull up reports, all with inside of Microsoft Teams. I almost said Power BI Teams. And then go to apps and you can navigate apps. A little bit of inception here, a Power BI app inside of a Teams app, all in a good day's work. All right, so we've got the app inside of Teams. It allows for the Power BI home region to be available while you're in Teams. You don't have to go anywhere. The things I like about this is that if you are a strong Teams user, so you live in Teams, and you do a lot there, this gives you the option of staying within Teams, which I like. The other thing that is very cool about this is it gives you options, right? So if I choose that I wanna do this inside of Teams, I can do that. If I don't wanna do it in Teams, I still can go to the webpage and go to the portal in the browser and do that, even if I'm on devices where maybe I don't have access to Microsoft Teams for whatever reason. I like the option aspect of this. I can work in the way that I want to work. So this is just giving me more flexibility, which is always cool. But wait, there's a few more things. So if we are inside of Teams, anyway, if we're inside of General, if I wanna do a conversation, there is an option down below. You'll see the Power BI icon. If I select that, then I can actually go ahead and choose different items and add that into the conversation. And bam, it's right there. Now in the blog post, it did mention that some of the links would open up directly in the app, but when I've been clicking on this, at least at the recording of this video, it opens in a browser. So I don't know if that's gonna change or not. Hopefully it does, and life will be good there. The other thing I don't know is why isn't the new icon used? Hopefully that'll be coming soon as well. If you'll notice in the recording of this, it's still the old icon that was used. And so hopefully that'll get updated as well. Maybe later this month, maybe next month. Who knows? All right, I want to hand this off to you. What do you think? Are you using Microsoft Teams? Do you like the addition of Power BI inside of Teams? Or are you going to stick with the web browser? Let me know in the comments below. I want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.